What up, everybody? So here is the moment a lot of you have been waiting for. Quite a while ago, I put out this video announcing a $15,000 editing competition. And now all the results are in, all the best ones are posted on my channel, and I could not be happier with the incredible entry submitted to this competition. So firstly, I'm gonna read some emails and do a live reaction, as in my genuine first time watching any of these competition entries. And then I'm gonna announce the results, all of the judges' individual scores, and ultimately, prize money, top three. Before we dive into it, thank you everyone so much for your entries. If you did enter this competition, I absolutely saw your entry, and maybe it wasn't good enough to be uploaded, but I can guarantee you I watched it, I enjoyed it, and it did not go overlooked. So thank you absolutely everyone who entered. Let's get into it. Next up, we got Tocker3. The title is pronounced Tosca, by the way. Already got that wrong. It's Russian. The music was created for this video by my friend Joel. Fun fact, the hi-hat in the music at the 1.6 part is from the main menu from 1.6 when you move your cursor over the options. Okay, cool. Some of the frags were from my friends and some were from pro matches. Hope you like it. Train on train, like Inception style. That is super sick. Loving the depth of field, loving the like panoramic zoom style effect. The vertigo effect, I forgot that one was called. Sick transition, classic, through the eye. Ooh, portal transition as well, with a cube in the background, edited in that. He's got the 4x3 and then he's kept all the models out of it, and the no gravity on the model is actually so cool. Super creative transition. Stunning visuals. Oh, look at that. No way is that transition to 1.6. It's a multi-game frag movie. That's super sick. Super hot! You gotta love that game. CS in super hot style. So creative. So professional. So well done. I feel like me just talking is ruining it a little bit because it's so sick. Zenyatta CT on acid. Everything is so crisp and clean and smooth. Really appreciate all the entries I got sent in. Unfortunately, I will only be showing the cream of the crop. Otherwise, this video is going to be ridiculously long. But everyone who tried and everyone who entered, massive, massive shout out to all you guys. Even if it was just to practice your editing skills, every single entry meant a lot. My name is Andrew. I'm a young 3D editor from Ukraine. It was a great journey in 3D for me. For this competition, I raised my skills in 3D from a beginner to a fairly high level. I spent about 3 months on this video, hundreds of blue screens and bugs, but despite that, I tried to bring the video to perfection. I hope to win a prize in your competition. Best wishes, Andrew. Pretty cool, I like it. The Gungnir. First time I've seen it in an Unreal environment. Loving that epic style he's gone for. Epic cinematic. That's what he's gone for. Not too crazy over-edited. Just focusing on flow. On sync. And then just the beauty of the visuals. Just CSGO in Unreal Engine. Nice flare. I really like the glow. He's completely changed that red line to a blue line. Sick. He's got the train coming past as he's mowing down the trees. Loving the tattoos as well. Some nice custom props and skins being used. Really, really beautiful entry so far. The environments just look so good. The tracked flare as well looks really cool. Nothing too crazy in terms of actual editing itself, but the 3D, the whole feel of it is sick. Really sick. Marcelli says, here's the link to my entry. Video was not published before and song used is copyright free. I produced myself and will publish it on Spotify without content ID there, so should be no issues on the copyright side.
I walk straight in, playing at Bogart, like I've done 100 times before.
What the hell is this?
The place was run by a couple of murdering mobsters with shark smiles.
Max Payne style. CSGO. The animation on this is insane.
Something ugly had been tattooed on the wall. A map of things to come. The Finito Brothers.
I'm a bit lost for words. I absolutely love the models. I love the theme. I love what he's done with it. I love the map design.
The door slammed shut behind me.
I love.
And then I was dodging bullets like raindrops.
The colors. I love the storyline. I love the camera work, that depth of field, even the physics on those little hanging lights that he's walking through. I can't stop grinning.
I didn't like the way the show started.
Genuinely, I can't. This is so nice so far. When have we ever seen an epic scene like that before? In CSGO, the slow-mo car crash with that creative, smooth, it's the camera angle going over at the same time. This is awesome.
A beaten-up phone in the entrance hall was ringing. It could have been just a junkie in need of a fix, but it turned out to be something more sinister than that.
You must hurry. The police are on their way.
Tell me something I don't know.
No, you're there.
Bravo, my friend. Bravo. Dyson, hello Sparkles, this is my entry for your editing competition 3.0. I hope you like it. Ooh, look at this color correcting. This makes the intro look even better than whatever the hell I did to it, which was pretty terrible. I like that. Cool. Okay. I'm ready. Very intense. I see why he put the epilepsy warning on. Tune. Big tune. The level of 3D edits in this competition so far is mind-blowing. Speechless. That's a nice one. I like that a lot. Oh, didn't expect that. We've even got the Rio de Janeiro Statue of Jesus over there. Got the Half-Life drones coming in. Everything about this is so spot on. Is that the actual lobby from Inception? Ridiculous. Ridiculous recreations. I absolutely love it. They've gone off the Gary's tower. There he is, G-Man, sitting there. It's so cool. It's like built up for the big boss fight. I feel like I missed so many of the reference in that. I feel like the amount of work and the amount of design that went into that, I honestly felt like I have to watch that at least 10 times to appreciate every single aspect of it, and believe you me, I will be. That was so good. Ethanks just straight up messaged me a link. The 3D CSGO movie. Very nice opening shot. I like it a lot. Loving the vibe. Loving the creativity. Loving the sync. Loving the animation. Loving the environments. Loving the crisp, clean detail. All of those little... That is a 6-6 smooth. I love that one. The skins as well used. Super, super cool. Those mummies. Pretty sure those are mummies.
that ended a little bit abruptly for me. I needed like a bit of a wind down scene or something like that, but that was still super sick.
So there is one movie I have been putting off reacting to for quite some time. And full disclaimer, I actually paid and helped to get this movie finished. This is why in the judging process, I am not going to be judging this movie. It will just come down to the average of the other judges, because that's highly unfair and highly biased if I paid for a movie to get completed and then I'm voting on it. So I don't want any of the integrity of the competition to be questioned. But this is The Funeral 3 by Danny Baron. I absolutely loved The Funeral 1 and The Funeral 2, old school CS movies, and I have been highly anticipating this, so let's go.
Danny Baron presents. Produced by Ghost Pictures. In association with Sparkles.
That's sick. You gotta love that movie voice. You gotta love it. Headset. Headset crew. Let's go. Same headset. Some nice actual real life cinematography getting involved in this. With some cool depth of field, some nice lenses, nice focus shift. Creates a really cool atmosphere, and the music as well, the vibe. Very Matrixy. The color correction as well on everything, being that blue. It's been thought about. It's been planned, it's been acted. That knock nearly got me. That fake knock nearly got me. Nearly turned around.
My good boy, you are the best cat ever. Oh, fuck, it crashed again.
Say, for example, you're Danny Baron, and you're doing a movie called The Funeral, and you want to give it like a tiny scary theme at the end of it or something like that.
If anyone's ever seen Fight Club, I think that song will bring back a whole flood.
Exclusive entry for the Sparkles editing competition.
They say fear is just a state of mind. A locked door.
Hopping in
the
whip.
But once you find the key to your terror, fear will
the drone shots. This is unbelievably sick so far, I'm not gonna lie. It's time. It is time. I love how Danny's in it. He's popping off with the AK.
Some of the 3D work on it is really nice. You've got to love the use of Unreal. That was a very sick transition as well through the vent. Such a nice throw, there it is. Sick.
Hi, the War Owl greets you. Make sure to subscribe to this channel, Danny Barron's, for high quality gameplays, gaming montages.
Got the War Owl's voice at the end. That's great. I felt like the focus of it was more on actually like the real life than the frag. Some of the frag scenes were really, really cool. Actually, I feel like the frag scenes let it down a tiny bit compared to the absolute epicness. There was everything before it. Got an entry here by Leaf. Here is the download link. Bottomless Cradle. Let's check it out. I was just about to ask if that was CS in like a cartoon style. And yes, it is. Sick. I see the heavy metal, death metal style that he's gone for. All the color correction. My favorite part so far has to be just the 2D work is absolutely incredible. Sick transition, very sick. Such a unique style as well. First time I've ever seen those raised, like following someone from the top. It's like, it's actually genius. I love it. The kill feed as well in like proper horror movie title style. I was not expecting this. Initially, I admit I wasn't a fan of the heavy metal style. I've already fallen in love with it. And that's it. Wow. Wow. That was awesome. That was incredible. What a cool entry. I think it's time to get into the judging and inevitably the winners. But firstly, let's introduce our panel of judges. First up, we have Viri. Viri is a CSGO movie maker. He runs a very successful YouTube channel and he's been doing this for a very, very long time. Brought him on board just because he has a whole extensive wealth of knowledge and he is more of the frag, highlight and flow type of edit. Judge number two. It's me! Now, although I have been out of the editing scene for quite some time, I did run a very successful editing team called Sparkles Prod back in like, what, 2009? And I do have a hell of a lot of knowledge about editing, 3D environments, and montages in general. Third judge, it is Retchie. Some of you may know him as Clayman90 from back in the day. He produced the legendary Incorporated 2, and he's been editing and doing this for a very, very long time, and has a lot of knowledge on the subject, so pleasure to have him on board as well. Fourth judge, Mazzarini. I wanted to keep the judging panel quite variant. Does that make any sense? Probably not. But what I mean is I wanted a variety of different editors or different people involved in the scene in different backgrounds. I didn't just want CSGO editors, CSGO editors, CSGO editors, because I thought people might complain that it might have a CSGO bias if all of the judges are primarily CSGO editors. So I was very lucky to have Mazzarini agree to join the project. He's edited a whole series of games. I don't think he's ever edited CSGO
CSGO, but he made the legendary Play With Soul COD 4 movie, has a huge background in Call of Duty in general, and has moved on to lots of other more recent games as well. Just a great person to have on board. Penultimate judge we have is Fuse. Now, Fuse is more like my expert in the 3D realm of things on the judge panel. He's created some absolute masterpieces in 3D, racking up millions and millions of views, and deservedly so. Real pleasure to have him on board. And last but not least, we have Enigma. I don't know if you guys know Enigma or not. If you don't, you should. He's been running the Enigma community for years and years now, which is an editing community. He constantly streams editing style stuff, and his whole world is just editing, so he is maybe the best person to have on this entire judging team, to be honest. And he's not just a CS editor either. He's done loads of stuff like Valorant, even Fortnite. So each judge was given a Google document sheet to fill in and rate all the entries on. First up was Viri. He put Blinding Lights as number one overall. It got a 9. The Funeral 3 also joint number one. It got a 9. And the Finito Brothers, he put as number 3 with an 8.6. I'm only going to be covering the top 3 because the top 3 are the only places that get prizes. But as you can see, we rated a lot more than just the top 3. When looking at my scoring compared to all the other judges, I was a bit more generous with basically every single entry. Perhaps because I started the competition and I just absolutely loved all of the entries I received. But here's how I had it. Blinding Lights, joint first with Finito Brothers, both getting a 9.8. And then joint second was Bottomless Cradle and Tocker with an 8.2. You'll notice the Funeral 3 is right at the bottom and it says can't vote. Therefore, the final judging of the Funeral 3 is only divided by the 5 judges instead of the 6 judges, leaving me out. Moving on to Retchie, who also had Blinding Lights as number 1 with a 9.6. Finito Brothers got number 2 and the Funeral also got number 2. They both got joint place 2 with 9.0. Now we move on to Mazzarini's votes. And as soon as I saw what he'd marked down a lot of the entries as, I questioned him and I was like, most people have Blinding Lights or Finito Brothers number 1. Why did you put Bottomless Cradle as number 1? And he told me ever since Clockwork 4, he feels like the Unreal environments have been incredibly overused, and he was frankly sick of seeing movies in that style, and Bottomless Cradle for him was incredibly different and incredibly impressive. So obviously all the judges are completely entitled to their own opinion. That is why I brought them on board on the project, and it's actually nice to have a refreshing change of opinion. So he put Bottomless Cradle as number 1 with a 9.4, Blinding Lights as number 2, and then Misfit as number 3. Moving on to Fuse. Now, Fuse gave a hell of a lot of feedback here in his little spreadsheet. I'll put all the links to the judges voting down below, so if you guys want to personally read this, you can. But he's put Finito Brothers as number 1, he's put Blinding Lights as number 2, and he's put Tocker as number 3. Reading a little bit from his notes, he says, Dyson's and Morrow's work, which are in my opinion are just another level world when it comes to both game editing and this competition. They are more like CGI short films, whereas if you would have switched to CSGO models to COD or Valorant or Battlefield or whatever, they would still feel really similar. CSGO is just the game of choice for them. I think he makes quite a valid point. If all of the models were replaced with a different game model, it doesn't really matter. It's actually just the fact that this beautiful CGI movie has been created, and it's about the feels of the movie, not even which particular game it's actually focused on. And that is probably why Mazzarini actually voted them a lot lower than all of the rest, because he values more actual frag editing and presumably using the game's engine to the maximum potential. And last but not least, we have Enigma. He gave Blinding Lights a solid 10. 10 over every single category that we were judging. Finito Brothers following in very closely with a 9.92, and then Iron actually with the third place. I'm not going to say anything about any of the judges' rulings because there is a reason I brought them all on board, and at the end of the day, it is actually a personal preference. There is no real scientific way to score all of these entries. I tried my best with all of these different categories, but when it truly comes down to it, it's feels within and what is really evocative for you personally, and that is very different for everyone. So the very final results, let's go. Coming in at third place is Bottomless Cradle. This was such a cool and unique movie and seemed like such an incredible journey for him as well as like a 2D animator. You could tell there was a really big improvement from just at the start of the movie, all the animations, and at the end he literally got a whole other level up. And it was an incredibly unique movie, which I think is very deserving of third place. Second place, little drum roll, It is The Finito Brothers. Now, the minute I clicked play on this movie, I was just completely blown away. I myself am a massive fan of the Max Payne series. It really takes me back to my childhood. So to see this like trippy, incredibly high detail, incredibly well animated. Personally, for me, actually, the animation of Finito Brothers was a little bit higher than Blinding Lights. And if you talk about feels, this movie gives you some of that, slapping you right in the face with them. Massive congrats to Maro for the second place. Which leaves, you guys probably know already, the very first place, the winner of this competition. It is Blinding Lights by Dyson. Now, I don't know whether it's D-Y-S-N or Dyson. I'm just gonna say Dyson, but huge, huge congratulations to you, my man. This movie was just on another level. Everything about it was just so, so good. The length of the movie as well just really stood out. It was just a whole storyboarded masterpiece. Who would have thought the Weeknd song would have fit so incredibly well in like a frag movie? But this was so much more than a frag movie. This was just brilliance. There's no other way to put it. Huge congratulations to the top three winners. You will all be getting your prize money sent out quite shortly. I'll be contacting you. And massive, massive thank you to everyone who entered the competition. Some entries really, in my opinion, deserve to be top three, but there weren't enough top three spots for them to fit in. We had so many amazing entries into this competition. It was unreal. So I cannot thank all of you enough for being involved in this competition. I had an absolute blast watching all of the entries, every single last one. I really hope this whole competition maybe inspired some flames within people and relit a passion for editing, or gave birth to a passion for editing. Even if you're a complete beginner, it doesn't hurt to get your hands on some software, mess around. You'll be amazed what you can create, and you'll be amazed how rewarding the process is at the end of it. Thank you everyone so much for watching. If you think this editing competition was a good idea, make sure to let me know by hitting that like button. Hope you guys have an amazing Christmas and an amazing new year, and I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy. Peace.